All right, so after looking around the internet and on the forums for a good battery enclosure, the only one I can really find out there is a product made by SFK, Sun Fun Kits. There's no tape, there's no glue, not like these what you find in these pre-made batteries. It's a very quality enclosure. I'm glad to feature their product. Let's crack into the box and see what we got. And these are the parts that come with the version 4 kit. This is the BMS plate. The BMS mounts underneath these straps here, made of fiberglass. This is the balancer plate. So your balancer, active balancer, would mount here. This plate goes in between this and the BMS plate. This is the retaining plate. This goes on top of your cells. And these are the spacers that go on either side of the retaining plate and to basically make the cells sit flush with the retaining plate. These are the shims that come with the kit, a 1.5 millimeter and a 1.0 millimeter. These add the necessary compression to your cells. Put these in between your cells. And these are our power cables. We have battery minus, battery positive, and power negative. All right, so these are the cells I'm going to be using for this battery pack. Well, this will be a 12-volt battery, so we need obviously four cells to make a 12-volt battery. It is 299 amp hours. This one tested in at 297. This one was 299, and this one also was 299. So if you have like subpar cells that are bloated, you probably want to go with the 1 millimeter, because once you put them in the box, it's a very tight fit. But since I have pretty much pristine cells with no bloating, currently at 40% state of charge, we're going to try to go ahead and use the 1.5 millimeters. First, start with cell number one. Do the main battery negative. Put cell number four in on the end. Put a couple shims. Make sure the smooth surface is against any cell that's going to be moving up and down, so it's not scratching.
About how the fact that you're starting from the outside in to be able to slide them in.
Right. This is pretty hard to push these in. It's going to require a bit of force, so rather than pushing up against the foam and trying to potentially scratching against the aluminum, we want to make a gap here so that we can basically wedge and weasel the cell in. Again, make sure the smooth surface is facing the last cell so it doesn't scratch. Check our polarity. Minus, plus, minus, plus, minus, plus. And here we go. You want to help me with this, Keith? We'll just, can you just maybe expand that? Bet you're not bad at all. When you have good cells, wow.
Yeah.
I thought it would be harder. This is actually, could have probably used a 2 millimeter shim, but yeah, once she gets in there. That's actually a really nice fit. This is actually serviceable. You know, if you got a bad cell, you can replace it.
Yeah, that's awesome.
So that's pretty much the cell orientation with our main positive here, and a main negative down here. First thing that we have to put on are the shims. This one with the notches outwards goes on the right side, and this one with the notches leftwards goes on the left side. Next, we can put our battery retaining plate in place. Now, in reference to the main positive here and the main negative here, the retaining plate with the three holes goes on the top and the two holes goes on the bottom. So just remember when you're assembling that your main positive, a plus sign here, your main negative is right here. We use these bolts, supplied bolts, to put in to secure the plate in place. time to put our bus bars on. Since we're going from positive to negative, positive to negative, positive, negative, positive, negative, we're basically creating a series out of these cells. So the first bus bar is going to go here. Second bus bar goes here. And the third goes here. We just made a chain, essentially. Bus bar is just sitting on the terminals. The voltage at our main positive and our main negative, and we should get 12 volts. 12.99. Perfect. This is the BMS I'm going to use. This is the JK4-8. It's a 2 amp balancer. It can handle anywhere from 4 to 5, 6, 7, or 8 cells. 200 amp. And this is the wiring harness that we're going to use to connect the BMS to the cells. So this minus is our main negative or ground for the BMS, and this last red wire is the main positive for our BMS. These four wires we're not going to use. This is for cells 5, 6, 7, 8. We only have 4 cells. This first wire goes to cell 1. The second wire goes to cell 2. The third wire goes to cell 3. And the fourth wire goes to cell 4. And you notice that the fourth wire and the last wire, fourth and last, are tied together. That's because they both need to go to the last cell. This needs 12 volts to operate the BMS, and this also, cable number 4, has to read cell number 4. So we tie these together. This plugs in your BMS just like this. Now what we're going to do is cut these to length because we don't want to have so much wire. Get some heat shrink. Alright, we're first going to do our main power and cell number 4, which connect to the same terminal. Put our heat shrink on first. Put our ring terminal on. Make sure that you have a little bit of wire poking out right there. That way you know you have good contact. Don't get the insulation caught in the crimp portion. Get our standard crimpers out here. Good. Now we can do the rest of our wires. Now we have all the crimps made. Next we're going to use the heat gun. The harness is complete. And now we can connect our harness up to our battery cells. Alright, so this is our main negative here. It's going to go over here. I'm just going to hand tighten it for now. It's cell number 1. So it goes to the positive. And finally, cell number 4, positive, and our power at 12 volts here for BMS connection, BMS power. That's it. Now when we probe this connector here, we'll probe each lead here to make sure we have the appropriate voltages at the appropriate pin. It's very important that you do this. So we're going to put our negative lead on the negative. The first pin will be the first cell. So we'll have 3.25 volts. Next one over should be 6 point something, 6.5. And then again, add three more volts, 9.75. And find the last pin, 12.99 for cell number 4. Also at the very end here, it should also read 12.99. Perfect. We want to test the BMS, make sure it comes on and powers up and can read all the cells. So the blue cable goes to battery minus. Our black cable goes to P minus. That's our power out. Now we can connect it to our battery. So B minus. Goes here. We want to put the battery connection on the bottom. Put your smaller BMS wire on the top. Basically, main negative, main positive. Plug in the display. This display also has a power switch right on the side for this BMS. You can actually turn the battery on and off. Now we can connect the harness to the BMS. We should, at this point, be able to turn on the BMS. There it is. It's reading 12.9 volts. Perfect. Let's connect up our main positive. I just want to organize these wires a little bit. Next, we're going to use our torque wrench. We're going to set it to about 45 inch pounds. Now we're just going to go around and make sure these are all tight once again. Next thing we're going to do here is hook up our temperature sensor. So I'm going to put one sensor here on the upper right on cell number 1, and then on the lower left here on cell number 4. Now we can put in our balancer plate. Next, the three holes, 1, 2, 3, go line up to 1, 2, 3, and the bottom two holes, 1, 2, 1, 2 in the bottom. We can use this hardware. There's only these three bolts. These holes and these holes right here will be left empty because when we mount our BMS plate, we'll be using the same screws to hold both plates down. Then we have to take one of these off. See these little tabs on the BMS? The stock mounting holes, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Those little tabs just slide underneath that strap, just like that. BMS is mounted. So this is the hardware for these two screws at the top are the short ones, and the ones at the bottom are the longer ones. Very good. So now we can plug in our temp sensor. Connection. Okay, all the cells are there. The lid's got these two little dimples. I think I'm just going to use that as a reference. It's a tiny little drill. Oh, look at that. Okay, just a conservative amount of hot glue. Oops. Put the lid. It just has to go like this. Has to be right at that angle. See if we can torque this down a bit. Our display / power switch. If we can get the lid on, just get these bolts started. All completely down. Got a nice flush fit. Now we can plug in our display and enable charge and discharge on the BMS and see if it works. Turn on the BMS. There it is. Okay, now we're going to enable charge and discharge on the BMS. Now we should have voltage at the terminals. 13.11. Looks good. Got a little 10 amp charger. It'll take 28 hours to charge this battery. So currently, we see 0 amps on the output here. Charger starts, 0.9 amps, 9.1 amps, we are charging. Well, it's the next morning and we are at 100% now. I'll be doing another build video, the same battery, except it'll be the heated version, so we'll be able to see how the heating pads work. Well, that's it for this build video. If you guys want to see more build videos, please let me know in the comments below. If you're interested in SFK's product, there's a link in the description below. And as always, thanks for watching. Let me know in the description. Yeah, in the description, let me know. Yeah, that's good.